when you think between organic and natural, the difference comes. Whereas in the organic, you are giving something substitute to fertilizer. Whereas in natural, we are not giving substitute. We are rejuvenating the earth, where you will get everything. For example, in a forest, a tree will go, lot of fruits and the flowers will be coming. And nobody is going to give any watering or any pesticides or any farmyard manure or anything. Still you are getting it. The same thing we thought in natural farming. We are not giving any substitute to your pesticides or a fertilizer like that. What we are making is fully fertile land. All organicism should come from the earth. That is the theory of natural farming. And natural farming, when you do it, we don't have much expenses. Say for example, keeping one native cow, you can do 30 acres of agriculture. You can ask how. The theory in our natural farming is that per day, per month, for 1 acre, you require only 10 kilo of cow dung and 5 to 8 liters of cow urine. One cow can give you every day about 10 to 11 kilos of cow dung, 8 to 10 liters of cow urine. That means one cow can feed you for 30 acres. That is that thing. But how to collect and all these things, technical problems there. But still, even if it is come for one cow, come for 1 month also is good. There you are not putting your extra money on that. And how good fertile land it will become, how it will act, you can think. See, when you make your own Jivamrita and other things, when you put it to the earth, the microorganism start. It double every seconds. See, 10 liters of your Jivamrita, when you put it, we can easily do it for acre like that. So action, that you can see, if you walk through all these things, you can see lot of your worms, natural, not your vermicompost where you think that is not a worm at all. We call it the Ethnopetida. It is only surface eater. Whereas our earthworms, which are coming from the earth, when it comes, it will not come simply. It brings all the elements which is available in the earth. And what is the plant required? Everything will come from there. For example, 1 acre of land, Jivamrita, when you put it, we have calculated in scientifically 160 tons of your compost will come there. For example, 1 square feet of this thing, about 4 earthworm will come. And 4 earthworm comes, it gives and that will convert into so many fertile. And all the elements, 21 elements, what is required, everything will come in that. Whereas your theory of your chemical farming is you are going only NPK. That means the plant requires so many things, but you are giving only 3 items. There, how can it come? Actually, when you consider it, nothing is required from you for the plant. It takes 98.5% from the atmosphere. That is panchabhootagal. In spite of that, we still think about we have to make fertile land, we have to add that, we have to use this, we have to use pesticides. All these things, it is only illusion. That means waste of money and time. My